In this video, we'll show you how to use the Easy Drive configuration tool to easily access and change settings to meet your calibration and configuration needs. To download the software, visit Amerson.com and open the Fisher Easy Drive Electric Actuator page. Scroll to the bottom of the page to find the free configuration download. With power supplied to the board, the Easy Drive configuration software will connect to the Easy Drive actuator at startup and automatically populate the present settings. On the Control tab, select your desired method to control the valve. In this video, we will show 4 to 20 milliamp positioning. If this selection is not available, a license will need to be installed. Insert the license key included with your Easy Drive electric actuator purchase. If you do not have a license key, contact your local Emerson representative. After inserting the license key, select Manage Licenses. Move the license from the key to the valve. Verify the positioning license has been installed before removing the license key. Select 4 to 20 milliamp positioning and click Apply. The function of the control signal can be modified with the settings in the control section. The loss of signal position determines where the valve will move to if the input signal drops below 3 milliamps. The low travel cutoff is the minimum position setting the valve moved to before moving fully closed. The dead band is the minimum change in input signal before a move will occur. Retries determine how many times the valve will attempt to move following a motor stall. Changes to these values will result in the background color changing and a section labeled Pending Changes to appear. Adjust the control variables accordingly and click Apply to confirm all changes. Once you've adjusted the values to your requirements, you're ready to calibrate the span. This is required to make the valve move. First, verify the valve type selected matches your valve. If the valve type doesn't match, click the System tab, Advanced button, and select the appropriate valve type, and select Apply. Press Calibrate Span. Wait for notification that calibration is complete. In the Calibration tab, calibrate opened to closed values. Select 4 to 20 milliamp level and click Apply. The Gen 2 Easy Drive controller has a mode specifically created for heater-treater level applications where the transmitter is connected directly to the valve. It allows different open and close points to be configured. If the valve is closed, it will not open until the signal is above the open position, at which point the valve will open to that level and modulate normally. The valve will then close when the signal drops below the closed signal and not reopen until the open signal has been reached. Next, the Digital Auxiliary Input-Output section provides the flexibility of an additional local digital input or output. If the IOS is set to input, closing a contact connected to the digital input terminals will result in the valve moving to that loss of signal position. If the IOS is set to output, the input will turn on when the valve is fully closed, fully open, or in position as selected. The output is capable of delivering 25 milliamps at 10 volts DC. Lastly, you can name the valve in the connection. Select the Connection tab and click on Device Name. Modify this field with the valve name of 20 characters or less. You've now successfully wired and set up your Easy Drive electric actuator. Contact your local sales representative or visit Amerson.com to learn more. Thanks for watching.